So what you just saw was me controlling a digital piano through our app FIFOX on my smartphone. Now, before you get overexcited, let me put a little disclaimer here. FIFOX is an app designed to allow students to use the sensors in their smartphones to do physics experiments. It's not designed to do the stuff you see here. So all I'm doing is showcasing FIFOX's ability to share the sensor data, and this is more like fooling around at the end of the year than actually the application for this app. So unless you know a little bit of Python, so you do some coding yourself and you really know you round away digital instruments, it would be really hard to reproduce what you see here. But if you want to, you will find the script I use in the video description. So allow me to quickly explain how this works. FIFOX shares the sensor data through a web server, which I read through a Python script, which then in turn sends MIDI data to a musical instrument or a digital audio workstation. Alright, there might be a few words in the sentence which you don't know, so let me explain this step by step.
As mentioned before, FIFOX is an app to read the sensors in your smartphone, so they can be used in physics experiments. If you are interested in this, check out our channel or FIFOX.org to see a range of examples. FIFOX has a feature to control its experiments from a second device. All you need for this is a modern web browser. But instead of opening the interface in a web browser, we will retrieve the data directly with Python, a programming language. If you are a developer and interested in doing this for your own projects, you can find a documentation of our API in the wiki on FIFOX.org. So, we are able to read out the data from the accelerometer in Python. Now we only need to generate some commands for our musical instruments. Luckily, there's a standard for this, called MIDI. Pretty much every decent digital instrument since the 80s has a MIDI port, often for both directions, so your digital piano can send the notes you play to a synthesizer, but it can also retrieve the notes from another device, for example from a Python script. Also, music software can be controlled through MIDI without a cable by software on the same device. Examples would be virtual synthesizers or digital audio workstations. MIDI can also send so-called continuous control messages. Those are not notes, but parameters that influence notes. For example, the sustain pedal of the e-piano sends such control messages, or the opening of the hi-hat of a digital drum set is represented by those control messages.
For non-drummers, hi-hats are those weird cymbals that are opposite to each other and which you can control with your foot.
And of course, we can also control the hi-hat with our smartphone. So each hit is a note generated by the drum kit, but the opening of the hi-hat is a control message from our Python script. Or we could control the effects in an audio workstation to create a low-cost wah-wah pedal for a guitar. Or we could use the phone to switch between electronic and natural drum sound by tilting our head. we could...
Alright, I think you got the point. You can do a lot with this. If you know some Python and are into music, check out the script I use in the video description and play around with it. Also, I'd like to thank Fernando from Portugal, who is a musician and composer, who came up with this idea by asking me if VFox could generate some music. Also, keep in mind, this is not what VFox is designed for. If you don't know VFox yet, check out VFox.org or check out the examples on our channel. So long, have fun experimenting with VFox, happy new year, and see you soon in another video.